Welcome back. Now, dubbed the dessert king, he was the early favourite to win this year's MasterChef. But last night, Australia held its breath as Reynold was eliminated from the kitchen.
Reynold, you brought us a delicate, pretty version of Brett's dish, highlighted by the fineness of that cannelloni skin. But there was one detail that we couldn't overlook. Your fish was overcooked on the underside. It was dry. And from all of us, we're really sorry, but you're going home today.
Across Australia could be heard. Reynold joins us this morning. Please make it for him. Yeah. Reynold, Australia is understandably shocked. How are you feeling today? Was it just a case of, you know, lost concentration?
Yeah, it's just, you know, the pressure really got to me, like, especially 5 seconds, just, you know, just make a break time. 5 minutes is not plenty of time to play it up. So, you know, obviously trying to cook that fish, which is so delicate and so easily overcooked, It's really tough.
It was just extraordinary. I thought right from the very first episode, I thought, right, this kid's going to win this. He's going all the way. So I am one of those people who's shocked. There was some controversy over the quality of your dishes, though.
Yeah, you know, stuff like that are bound to happen. You know, if anything, stuff like that, it's like a compliment to me. I really want to be on that level. And but, you know, going up is quite tough for me. Obviously, people think that I've learned from my mum.
And this was also because you grew up. Your family, I think, run the restaurant. You grew up working in that restaurant, but in the kitchen.
Just as a delivery driver and as a kitchen hand. Like growing up, I'd be coming home to school, like from school, home alone. So I'd be, you know, obviously cooking, looking cookbooks and just practicing myself. Because, you know, my mum wouldn't really have time to be there for me much, because supporting for the family and stuff like that.
You are incredible at desserts. I have the biggest sweet tooth, and watching the desserts you would make, I just wanted to eat them. Where did your love of desserts come from?
I think my love from desserts just came from the dishes from different cookbooks, such as Alinea or, you know, Key and Sapia. So those kind of desserts, plated desserts, really inspire me, and I'm trying to try to draw inspiration from that, and as well as from just, you know, from nature.
Do
and
you
environment.
Like to eat them too?
I'm not a huge sweet tooth, to be
honest. Oh, what?
Yeah.
So good at it. Reynold, is it true that your parents didn't want you to be a chef? And what do they think about it now?
Not just my parents, but my brothers too, because they've seen that side of the industry is really tough. And obviously, us growing up, it was quite hard for us. But, you know, I just stuck to it and stuck with my guns and just, like, really want to follow my passion. I try to study, and I just don't feel any passion for that, so that's why I went.
You're obviously a talented cook, that's for
Thank
sure.
You surprised the judges over and over again. Did that make you feel satisfied?
Yes, but every time I would be very surprised, because I really never expect that kind of feedback.
No.
Yeah.
That's great.
How would you sum it up? Was it a good experience for you?
It was probably one of the best experiences, not only just having to learn about cooking and stuff like that, but, like, having to learn about what I'm capable of. And, you know, nothing is impossible with hard work.
Look, we know the world is at your feet, but tell us what you want to do right now.
Well, later on this year, my brother and I will be opening up a dessert bar, and I'm looking forward to do a pop-up, you know, later next month.
Where? Where's that going to be?
plans are still underway, so, you know, still thinking about whereabouts to go, and, you know, things are still underway. But, you know, I'm still trying to get experience, so I'm working at Gastropark with Grant King, who did the pressure test dish on Monday. So I'm just trying to absorb and learn as much as I can.
Okay, so we're down to the finale, the last couple of days. Who do you think's going to win?
Any three of them could take it out, but I think Billy, because she handles pressure really well. I'd say so, yeah.
Did you think you were going to win? Did you think, I've actually got this? Because one of your undoings was that you were so good so early that people almost thought the fix is in.
It seemed like I peaked too early.
You didn't.
No. I didn't think so, to be honest, because I just wanted to survive. Winning wasn't really in my mind at that point in the competition, but when I got closer, it did start to become a possibility.
Well, we know you surprised Australia, but not yourself, because you're an incredible talent, and we really will watch your journey with great interest. Please congratulate Reynold for an incredible series on MasterChef. You did yourself and your family very proud. Don't forget, the grand final of MasterChef will air this Sunday night from 7:30 right here on 10.